Brain of Britain, the nationwide general knowledge contest, chaired by Russell Davis.
And a warm welcome once again to the Radio Theatre in London for the latest heat in our 2018 tournament. Only time will tell whether any of the four shining faces before me, come the summer, will be the 65th Brain of Britain. Let me invite today's competitors to introduce themselves.
Hello, my name's Beverley Beesley. I'm an editor and I live in Essex.
Hello, I'm AMIT from Surrey and I work in finance.
Hello, I'm Jill GOODWIN from Swindon and I'm retired.
Hello, I'm Ian Porter. I'm a retired accountant from Great Yarmouth.
Thank you. The rules are straightforward, well established. All you really need to know is that the questions are worth a point apiece, and the opportunity to win a bonus point comes in the order in which you flash your lights at me. So your reflexes need to be keen if you're going to pick up points on other people's questions. You have 10 seconds to answer your own question, and when your time is up, you'll hear this unmistakable signal. Don't forget, you'll also be awarded a bonus point if you get 5 answers correct on the trot, but that will also mark the end of your turn. Good luck, all four of you. We go in alphabetical order of surname, so the first round starts with you, Beverley Beesley. In Longfellow's poem, who is Hiawatha's love interest, as they say?
Minnehaha.
Yes, in the Song of Hiawatha, published 1855. Which term, beginning with R, is used for the items in the crown jewels of the United Kingdom that are used in the coronation ceremony? Out of time. Ian Porter?
Regalia.
Regalia, yes. And they include the orb and sceptre and the imperial crown of state. The word itself doesn't exclusively refer to the UK's ceremonial trappings, of course. Amit Day. In the name of the North London newspaper, the Ham and High, Ham and High are abbreviations of which two districts?
Hampstead and Highbury?
No. Jill Goodwin.
Hampstead and Highgate.
That's the correct answer, yes indeed. And we come to your question. The new president of the African state of Liberia, elected in January 2018, is which former Chelsea footballer?
George Weah.
Yes, indeed. The longest land border any European state shares with another is that between which two countries?
France and Germany.
Not that one, no. Beverley Beesley?
USA and Canada?
No. Any more tries? Yes, Amit.
Russia and Ukraine?
No. Yes, Ian Porter.
Ukraine and Poland?
No. Much longer is Norway and Sweden, usually reckoned to be 1,619 kilometres in length. Ian Porter, your question. Which Italian football club is known as La Vecchia Signora, or the Old Lady?
AC Milan?
No, not. Amit Day?
Juventus.
Yes, Juventus, by no doubt intentional contrast, is the Latin word for youth. And that's the end of the first round. This is a nice even spread of scores. Everyone has one, except Jill Goodwin, who has two. Well done. And back to Beverley Beesley. Native to Central Africa, what type of animal is a bongo?
An antelope?
Yes, it's among the largest of the species. Spectacular looking, but very shy. And aren't we all? In Greek mythology, which youth became cupbearer of the gods, having been carried off to Olympus by Zeus in the form of an eagle? No. Jill Goodwin?
Ganymede.
Ganymede, yes indeed. Ganymede is also the largest satellite of which planet?
Jupiter.
Yes, in fact, it's the largest satellite anywhere in the solar system. It's well known that there really was a Richard Whittington who became Lord Mayor of London. But in which century did he first rise to that office?
15th.
No. Ian Porter?
14th.
14th, but only just, in 1397. Yes, he had 3 spells as Lord Mayor, 1397 to 99, 1406 to 7, and 1419 to 20. Jill Goodwin, we've come round to your question. In a fondly remembered scene in the television comedy Yes, Prime Minister, Jim Hacker says that the Daily Mirror is read by the people who think they run the country, while the Times is read by people who really do run the country. Which newspaper does he say is read by the people who think they ought to run the country?
The Sun?
No. Beverley Beesley?
Telegraph?
No. Ian Porter?
Express?
No. AMIT?
The Guardian.
The Guardian is right. Well done, yes. Could have been the Morning Star, I suppose. Ian Porter, Topolino is the Italian name for which popular cartoon character?
Mickey Mouse.
Yes. What name, derived from the Greek words for upon and a plant, is given to plants that grow on or attach to another plant or object merely for physical support?
Epiphytes.
Epiphytes, not the same as parasitic plants. An obvious example is moss. In 2014, who was the first British theatrical producer to be inducted into Broadway's Theatre Hall of Fame?
Mendes?
No. AMIT?
Andrew Lloyd Webber?
No. Jill Goodwin?
Cameron Mackintosh?
Yes, I think it would have been unjust otherwise. It was indeed Cameron Mackintosh. End of round two. And still the scores are nicely evenly spread. Beverley Beesley, 2, AMIT 3, Jill Goodwin and Ian Porter, 4 apiece. All right, Beverley Beesley, time for the first musical extract of today's Heat, and you're about to hear a song by the Beach Boys, which provided the title of their 1971 album. I'll ask a question when we've listened.
Surf's up, board a tidal wave. Come about hard and join the young and often spring you gave. I heard the word, wonderful thing, a children's song.
That song, Surf's Up, was originally conceived by its composer, Brian Wilson, as part of a large-scale concept album which was never actually issued at the time, even though many of the constituent songs found their way onto other Beach Boys album releases. What was the title of that long-abandoned album? No. Not going to come. Ian Porter.
Smile.
Smile, yes. In 2012, an album called The Smile Sessions finally appeared, collecting the component songs together. AMIT, who, ironically, was the only artist who actually spoke in the Mel Brooks film Silent Movie?
Marcel Marceau?
Yes, the famous mime artist. Playing himself, he utters the word non. In a reciprocating engine, what shaft translates the reciprocating motion of the piston into rotational motion?
Don't know.
Don't know, right. Ian Porter.
Cam?
No, it's not the cam. Yes, Beverley Beesley.
Crankshaft?
Crankshaft, yes. Or crank. Jill Goodwin, the characters of Euphorion in Goethe's Faust, Lord Cadursis in Disraeli's Venetia, and Mr. Cypress in Thomas Love Peacock's Nightmare Abbey are all portraits of which major English poet?
Shelley.
No. Ian Porter.
Tennyson.
Not Tennyson, no. AMIT?
Byron.
Byron, yes, he was the only one notorious enough to go round all those destinations. Ian Porter, in 2009, Carol Ann Duffy became the first Scottish-born poet laureate, which would not have been the case had the title not been turned down in 1813. By whom?
Shelley?
No, AMIT.
Scott.
Sir Walter Scott, yes, he declined as he thought the role had fallen into disrepute because of the alleged decline in the quality of work displayed by previous title holders. End of another round. Here are the scores. Beverley Beesley, 3. Jill Goodwin, 4. Ian Porter, 5. AMIT 6. I quite a nice shape. Nobody's getting away. Beverley Beesley, back to you. In the ghost story, The Mezzotint, first published in the collection entitled Ghost Stories of an Antiquary, a picture comes to life revealing a young child's apparent capture by a corpse. Who was its author?
Henry James?
No. Ian Porter?
M.R. James?
M.R. James, yes, no relation. Montague Rhodes James, famous writer of chilling tales, and also at various points in his career a vice-chancellor of Cambridge University and the provost of Eton College. Right, Amit Day, some music for you now, and it's a national anthem. You just have to name the country.
Spain?
No. Jill Goodwin?
Japan.
Japan, yes. Not very familiar. Appropriately enough, the new Japan Philharmonic Orchestra were conducted by Seiji Ozawa. Jill Goodwin, your question. In the names of British wildflowers, the words maiden, cheddar, proliferous and Deptford can all be followed by which colour?
Blue.
No. Beverley Beesley?
White?
No. Amit Day?
Yellow?
No. Ian Porter, have a go.
What's left? Red?
No. That's the closest. It's pink. It's pink. Ian Porter, your question. According to G.K. Chesterton, democracy means government by whom?
The lowest?
No. He's capable of that sort of thing. Jill Goodwin?
Nobody.
No. Well, yes, Amit Day.
The ignorant.
I will give you that. He actually used the word the uneducated, but I think it comes to the same thing. Well done, yes. End of yet another round. Beverley Beesley still has 3. Jill Goodwin, 5. Ian Porter, 6. Amit Day, 7. Very close. Well, it is close, and it's now time to allow our contenders a few minutes comparative relaxation as we take a couple of questions suggested by a Brain of Britain listener hoping to beat the brains. If you can take your fingers off the buttons and work as a team on these. Please do confer away and come up with an answer you're all happy with. This won't make a scrap of difference to the scores, of course, but the question setter stands to win a prize if you can't deal adequately with both questions. Today, you face the ingenuity of listener Chris Clough, who emailed his ideas to brainofbritain@bbc.co.uk. As you can too, if you've ideas for questions you'd like to try out on our brains. Let's see how you get on with Chris's suggestions. He asks, what was distinctive about the film roles played by Stuart Gray in The Damned United, by O'Shea Jackson Jr. in Straight Outta Compton, and by Shooter Jennings in Walk the Line? The reason is the same in each case.
I think these were actors who were playing their own relatives in the films, something like that.
I've heard of the films, but that's about as far as it goes.
Okay, we're going to have a guess. These might be actors who were playing their own relatives in the films.
Can you be more specific about the relatives?
Their own fathers.
Yes! Well done! They all played their real fathers in their respective movies. Stuart Gray played his footballer dad, Eddie Gray of Leeds United. O'Shea Jackson Jr. played his rapper dad, Ice Cube. And the country singer Shooter Jennings played the country singer Waylon Jennings, who was, you won't be surprised to learn, his dad. Well, well got. So on to question two. Jacob, Jesus of Nazareth, King Solomon and Thomas the Apostle are the only biblical figures to have what specific kind of thing named after them?
Can't see any connection at all.
Crackers.
He's been a little bit devious with a couple of these. Think of other names for a couple of these figures, if you can.
No. Crackers.
No, I'm not. No, you mustn't say. The answer is countries of the world. Israel, according to the Bible, was the name given by God to Jacob in later life. El Salvador is named after Christ. Solomon gives his name to the Solomon Islands, of course. And St. Thomas is commemorated in the name of the state of Saint Tome and Principe, two little islands off Africa. Very clever questions, Chris Clough. Thank you very much. I'm minded to wonder if you, Chris Clough, are related to the great Brian, given the footballing connection in your first question. But regardless, you do win a book voucher prize and this grandfather of all rounds of applause. I mentioned our email address, but you're also very welcome to send us your ideas on paper, addressed to Brain of Britain, Dock House, Media City, Salford, M50, 2LH. We only need two questions from you, but please do feel free to send us more than two ideas and let us pick the ones we like best. Let's get back to the contest. Fingers on buttons again, everyone, as we start the next round with Beverley Beesley. A person known as a siffleur, or a siffleuse, if they were female, would do what in order to make a living?
Whistle?
Yes. The name given to a professional whistler. Ronnie Ranald is the first one I saw in action. I often delight my family with my version of his version if I were a blackbird, but I'll spare you that. How many dots form the matrix from which each individual letter in the Braille alphabet can be formed?
Nine?
No. Ian Porter.
Six?
Six is right. Yes, well done. AMIT Day. An official government census of the population has been held every 10 years in the UK since 1801, with one exception. When was that exception?
1901?
No. Beverley Beesley.
1941?
Yes, not an easy time to keep track of anyone or know that any given address was still existing. Jill Goodwin, it's your turn for a sound clip. The position of Speaker of the House of Commons dates back to medieval times, and here's the voice of someone who held the post in the 20th century. I'd just like you to name him.
I'm very mixed up, because my dear mother must be rejoicing in heaven, and I know that the people in the valleys will be as happy as I am, that one who grew up in great poverty in the valley, but with plenty of love in the home, has been honoured in this way. For me, it's not the title that counts. And, I mean, that's silly. I'd be the same shape in the bath as I was before. It's a load of tripe to think that the title makes a difference. But it does mean I shall, for the rest of my life, be linked again with the Houses of Parliament.
George Thomas.
George Thomas, Viscount Tonopandy, was the title he referred to. He held the position of Speaker between 1976 and 83. He was Thomas George Thomas in full, known in Wales as Tommy Twice. Always like that. Flecks of which inflammable metal are most commonly used to ensure a trick candle reignites?
Tungsten.
No. Ian Porter.
Sodium.
Nope. Amit Day.
Phosphorus?
No. Beverley Beesley, have a go.
Silver?
No. I thought you might get this. Magnesium, which goes off very easily. Ian Porter, according to the definition provided by Collins Dictionary, what name is given to the, quote, genre of science fiction that combines futuristic elements with a quasi-Victorian setting?
Science fantasy?
No. No, this isn't ringing a bell. Yes, it is, with Amit Day.
Gothic punk?
No. Any more tries? No. You weren't far off. Steampunk is the word they use, the term now also used for an aesthetic style inspired by steampunk fiction. And that's the end of a round, and the scores have closed up even more. Beverley Beesley, 5. Jill Goodwin, 6. Amit Day and Ian Porter, 7. Cannot pick a winner here. Beverley Beesley, Steinbacher, Grey Saddleback and Buff Saddleback are breeds of which bird?
Chicken?
No. Any more birds? Yes, Ian Porter.
Turkey?
No. Amit Day?
Ostrich?
No. They're getting bigger. Jill Goodwin?
Blackbird?
No, it's a goose. They are all geese. Amit Day, the anti-malarial drug quinine is derived from the bark of which tree?
Cinchona.
Cinchona tree, yes, C-I-N-C-H-O-N-A. The England cricketer Bob Willis added which singer-songwriter's name to his own by deed poll?
Bob Dylan?
Yes, he became Robert George Dylan Willis. The hairstyle always used to give that away, I thought, but there we are. In the Star Trek universe, the Klingons originate from which planet, whose name also happens to be that of a very successful quartet of musicians?
Vulcan?
No. Ah, oh, no. Ian Porter?
Not Romulan or something?
No. Don't think we're going to get this one, are we? No. Kronos, K-R-O-N-O-S. The Kronos Quartet is a very famous aggregation. They used to mix their classic repertoire with, for example, Jimi Hendrix numbers. Nothing if not eclectic. Jill Goodwin, in the titles of literary works from 1975, 91 and 1925, respectively, which word precedes buffalo, psycho and tragedy?
American.
Yes, David Mamet, American Buffalo. Bret Easton Ellis, American Psycho. Theodore Dreiser, an American tragedy. Snell's Law, named after Willibrord van Rooyen Snell, is the main law concerned with which specific physical phenomenon? Out of time, I'm afraid. Amit Day.
Refraction.
Refraction of light. You're right. Yes, indeed. And Ian Porter, music for you now. Leonard Bernstein was born 100 years ago this year, in August 1918. Here's an excerpt from the very last concert that he gave in 1990. I'd like you to name the piece he conducts here. It, but what was it?
Beethoven's Ninth?
No. Jill Goodwin?
Beethoven's Seventh.
Symphony Number 7, yes. We heard part of the Fourth Movement, and Bernstein was conducting the Boston Symphony Orchestra. Here are the scores at the end of that round. Beverley Beesley, 5. Ian Porter, 7. Jill Goodwin, 8. Amit Day, 10. And this, I do have to warn you folks, is the final round. Beverley Beesley, which is the most northerly horse racing course in Great Britain? No time left. Amit Day?
Is it Perth?
It is Perth. Yes, indeed, it is. And we come to you. In the 60s and 70s, the psychologist Walter Mischel led a series of studies and experiments on delayed gratification. These experiments take their name from a specific type of confectionery that Mischel and his colleagues used as a means of testing the self-control of preschool children. What type of confectionery?
Toffees?
No, it could have been. Ian Porter?
Marshmallow.
Yes, it's the marshmallow test. The idea was simple. One marshmallow now, or if you wait, you can have two marshmallows later. In my experience, quite a lot of children don't like marshmallows anyway. Might spoil the results. Jill Goodwin, Virtue Rewarded is the subtitle of which novel by Samuel Richardson, published in two parts in 1740 and 1741?
Pamela.
Yes. The planet Venus takes how many Earth days to orbit the Sun? You can have a couple of days leeway either side.
100.
No. Pick a number. Yes, Amit.
200.
No.
150.
No, Beverly Beesley. The range is between 223 and 227. It's more precisely 224.7. Ian Porter, arsine, a hydride of arsenic used in the manufacture of semiconductors, is extremely poisonous, but smells characteristically of a plant often used in cooking. Which one?
Fennel.
No. Jill Goodwin?
Almonds.
No. Beverly Beesley?
Basil.
No. Amit Dev?
Cinnamon.
No, it's garlic, I'm afraid. And that brings us to the end of the contest. The final scores in this third heat of Brain of Britain 2018 are as follows. Beverly Beesley, 5. Ian Porter, 8. Jill Goodwin, 9. Amit Dey, 11. Well done. And so it's Amit Dey who'll definitely be back for the semi-finals in a few months' time. Congratulations to him. But well done, all of you, for such a close contest. We'll meet another four competitors next week. In the meantime, from me and our audience here at the Radio Theatre, goodbye.